What's up, YouTube guys? We got another mechanic-in video here. A real short, easy one this time. We're putting some new shock absorbers on our car here, on account of these are 27 years old and they just don't absorb the shock anymore. Right here, I've already got started and done one side, that way I know what I'm talking about when I tell you guys what you're doing, and it's real easy. Like, see, this is the old shock. Shouldn't be compressed like that. They're supposed to rebound and whatnot, and I was able just to squish it together real easy. Like, these are 27 years old. Had to cut the top off, like I'm sure everybody has to. Show you what it looks like in here with your shiny new shock absorber. And then we'll go to the other side. See, it's blue now. And it's inside the center of the coil, which seems scary at first, but it's real easy. You just have to jack the car up far enough to slide it out underneath. You may be able to see it bolts up underneath the bottom right there, and it just right out the bottom after you cut the bolt off the top. So now we're gonna put the wheel back on this side, take the wheel off of that side, and I'll show you the easy couple things you got to do to replace your shock absorber. Now that you got your vehicle safely supported with a jack stand and you pulled your wheel off, the very next step of the operations, you can come in here. You might be able to see right there. Right there is the top bolt to your shock. You can either get this nut loose, which I tried again, and then I stripped the little square bit out on top that you hold still to get it loose. Most of the time you'll probably have to cut it off. So that's going to be our first step. We'll get in there with the Sawzall, make that bolt shorter, and then after that we can move on down. I should move the light on down to the bolts on the bottom. Now you have your old shock removed. The next one's gonna go in the opposite way. We just got a little hardware to stack on the top of it before we toss it up in there. Here's our new shock, and here's our new shock hardware. Now we gotta stack a washer on the bottom there, put one of these guys in on top of it, like so, and you'll notice that there's different size doomajickies on the bottom of this. In our car, this wider guy fits up nice and snug into where the shock mounts into on the frame rail, so this part goes like that, just that way, and then this will go up into that part in the frame rail and it'll lock in there. Then the next one goes on the opposite way, where you got the fat bit coming down and that sandwiches in that metal slot on the frame rail. So now we'll just take that and thank you. now we'll break out the torque. Well, actually, I don't know if I can break out the torque wrench. These things get torqued down to 11 foot-pounds, so I'll break out the torque wrench if it reads that low, but I don't know. And then, boom! Just like that, you have changed the shock absorbers in your front end. And we'll do another video on the back end when we get those shock absorbers. Till then, thanks for watching. Hopefully this helps somebody. Till then, thanks for watching. Maybe this really simple job helps somebody out there. Comment, like, subscribe. Bye.